Hi all, in this video I will show you the homemade DVR I used to record all my Teen Whoop footage I have on my channel. So here it is. I will show you the result I got with it. So as you can see, it's a lot better than what we have on Fast Shark. I will show you more footage a little bit later at the end of this video. So here it is. It's a new version of my previous DVR that I show in another video. I will recommend you to have a look at it because this one is basically the same but more convenient and a lot more easier to use in the field. So I use two boxes. The idea is one box does an upscaling to HDMI and feed the other box that does the recording. I did some modification, so I included a step down module 5 volt to directly power both boxes. I included a cable that you can use to connect to the video out of your Googles, like that for my HDO with rapid fire, for instance. There is a start and stop button. I included also a mic and a push button to choose the sound source between the sound source from the feed or the micro. I included a global power button that will power everything all at once, and the USB port that I used and that will hold the file. So here how it works. I have here a Fat Shark case with lithium. I plug the power and I power on. You have a green light here, red light here showing it's working, and I just have to press the record button and it turns red, meaning it is recording. If I click back, it blinks and goes back to green, and when it's green, solid, I can remove my SD card safely. Also, I added a strap to hook it to the battery, and eventually I can use also the same strap to hook it to my belt or something near me to carry it. So of course I removed some unused connectors to put my video cable, and I soldered it directly inside where the SCART input is. I have also hidden here a few cables that are used to provide the 5 volt power source. That's why I don't use the standard connector. Same for it, I don't use the 5 volt input because I have included a step down module inside. Here you have a button to switch PEL or NTSC depending on your kind of camera and the FPS you want to record. So for a PAL or NTSC camera, the other button, probably I never use them because this is to switch the input from HDMI or SCART, but I only use the SCART input, and I always use 720p because the recorder is only able to do 60 fps in 720p. It will switch back to 30 fps only if you throw 1080p at it.
Now I will show you what's inside. So here are the two boards from the both box after unboxing them. You see it weighs 135 grams. And here is the board inside the HD decoder with a step down module, step up, step down, and the power button and the mic installed.
So that's all. So I give you links to everything in my description, in the description of the video below, with a lot more details. And I leave you with more comparative footage done with a basic Mobila 7 with a bit of jello because he maybe had too much crashes. But forgive me about that. Thank you. Bye bye.
D'une hélice en vol. Il est juste au bord du grillage. Je pense que tu peux même l'attraper du bon côté. Ah, il est sympa, l'ensemble, je connais, il est super sympa à piloter. si, c'est bon.